Right. Are we live? Are we not live? I'm coming live from the phone, so I'm not really sure. Can somebody come around? Okay, it says live. Then I must be live. Okay. Guys, please give me a shout if my audio is okay. Yesterday we tried doing this and there was a problem with the audio, right? So give me a thumbs up, give me a hello, right? If you can see me, hear me, all right. Okay, good. So we are going live, and today's conversation, guys, that we're having is basically around networking for introverts, okay? And the fun fact is that I just completely forgotten that I was to do this live, I'd promised you, and I got a call from Tanuj asking if I'm live or not, okay? So, cool, let's get ready, let's jump in. Thank you for letting me know all as well, guys. Cool, so, core conversation for today. Networking for introverts. What do I want to do today with you? Right, I want to break this myth for you that a lot of people out there in the world have, where they believe that introverts are at a disadvantage when it comes to networking. That is just not true, right? In fact, being an introvert in many ways is an advantage. I want to create that opening for you today, okay? Cool, so we're gonna break this myth. And just by the way, if you're already ready to take your networking skills to a whole another level, check out networkingsuccess.in, right? This is the landing page for our upcoming three-day workshop. This is our biggest event we do, most successful training, most love training, NRPN, right? Do register for it. It's happening in April. Okay, let's jump in. So the most important question, the most asked question that I have received in the last 10 years of being a networking coach is people coming up to me and saying, but Paritosh, I'm an introvert, how can I network, right? Now, I'll come to the how in a bit, but before I come to the how, I want to discuss the why being an introvert is an advantage, and even before that, why introverts tend to struggle when it comes to networking, right? Because of two reasons. One, because they believe that they have a disadvantage. That's the reason number one, because of the belief that they have, right? And reason number two is that they see certain people networking, they see extroverts networking, and then they form a vision in their mind, oh, networking is supposed to happen like that, and because they can't do it like that, they say, oh, no, I can't network like Paritosh, I can't network like that person, I can't network like that person, right? And then they use that information to validate that they're an introvert, and because they can't do that, they can't network. And that's the myth that we have to break. Okay, so one of the first things that you have to break is a notion of how networking is supposed to be. There is no way. And in fact, everyone has their own way of networking. Some people network by being very loud and talking to every single person in the crowd, and some people network by talking to four people in a full day event. So stop having this notion of how networking is supposed to be. Now, look at this interesting fact. So why introverts have hesitation? Because they only see extroverts networking, because introverts are constantly feeling, I can't network, so they stay behind. They only see extrovert networking, one extrovert, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth. And they end up believing that because so many people are networking like this, networking is done like this. And that's just not the truth. Okay, cool. Now, why are introverts at an advantage? Let's talk about that. Now, before that, I want you to give you this very, very interesting figure. More than 50% people in the world are introverts. Imagine that, right? More than 50% people. So you're not alone with this, okay? And fun fact, absolute fun fact, I am an introvert, right? Given choice, I would not be doing Facebook Live. I would not be attending an event. I would not be doing anything else. I would be sitting at home with a book and chilling, listening to music, doing my meditation. I want to stay alone, right? I prefer that. But over time, I have mastered the ability to switch from one state to another. And that is possible. I want you to know that, okay? Cool. Now let's talk about why our introverts are at an advantage. Now look at this. Extroverts, what are they more likely to do? Two options. Are they more likely to share or are they more likely to listen, right? Type in the chat box. What do you think are extroverts. Extroverts more likely to do. Are they more likely to share what they have in their mind? What do they think about the world? What do they think about the politics, right? Or are they more likely to listen, right? Clearly, extroverts are more likely to share, right? And here is one very interesting thing I want to share with you. Over the last 10 years, I've done multiple surveys with people on what are their networking challenges, where did they get stuck the most. And one of the things that's most common in those surveys is people coming and saying, Parthosh, I don't get a chance to speak. Other people keep speaking all the time. How do I talk about myself, right? So what's happening? People are saying they want to be heard, right? They don't want to be spoken to. They want to be heard. Who is more likely to do that? An introvert or an extrovert? Right? Very clearly, an introvert. Right? An introvert is someone who, if that introvert can just master the ability to initiate a conversation, right? The game can completely change, because people, when they go to events, etc., they want to talk about themselves. And with extroverts, that can sometimes become a challenge. I'm not saying with all extroverts, but with some extroverts, it can become a challenge, right? So because introverts don't really want to talk about themselves so much, it's not that they don't want to talk about themselves. They don't want to talk about themselves so much, right? They have this inherent advantage over extroverts, okay? Now, let's talk about how can an introvert network successfully. It's a very short live, so I'm going to do this for another 2 minutes, and then I'll see you day after tomorrow or something. Okay, so here is how introverts can network successfully. Three things that you have to keep in mind. Number one, you have to understand what works for you, right? I said earlier, there's no one type of networking. And when you're an introvert, you have to figure out what kind of networking works for you. So let me give you a couple of examples. So there's big group networking and there's a small group networking, right? There's extremely structured, formal networking where you go to events and platforms and everybody stands up and says, good morning, this is who I am, this is what I do. And then there's informal, relaxed networking. There are events in places like that. You have to figure out what works for you. All those options are available today, right? And once you figure out what works for you, you have to do more of that. Big group, small group, formal, informal, right? Weddings, birthday parties, whatever works for you, right? There is no kind of networking that works for everyone, okay? Cool, so that's number one. Figure out what works for you. Step number two, okay? Develop the skill of starting a conversation, right? Fun fact, introverts and extroverts both struggle, both have this fear of how will I start a conversation? What will people think? Right? Extroverts make it look like that they don't have a fear. Don't believe that perception. Be very clear. Okay? But both introverts and extroverts have that fear of initiating a conversation. The only thing is extroverts tend to go do that more than introverts. Okay? So step two for you, for introverts, is learn how to start a conversation. Right? And how do you do that? By focusing on the other person, by talking to the person about them, going and saying, hi, I'm so-and-so, tell me about you, right? That's there. We'll talk more about it, okay? So as long as you can do that, you can have conversations with anyone. And believe me when I say, people love talking to introverts more than talking to extroverts, okay? So that was step number two. And let's come to step number three. And for this, I go to the beginning of the session. Stop believing that networking is of a certain way. Stop seeing the people around you and stop telling yourself, please, Hajarvalo, stop telling yourself, I can't do that. You're not supposed to do that. You're supposed to do what you can do. You take what you do and you get better and you get better and you get better and you get better, right? You're not supposed to network like me. You're not supposed to network like your friend. You're not supposed to network like anyone else. You're supposed to network the way you network, right? Three things very quickly, once again. Number one, discover what works for you. Big group, small group, formal, informal. Step number two, develop the skill of starting a conversation, having a conversation. It's just a conversation. You do that every single day, right? Just double up the skill. And number three, stop believing that networking is done a certain way. It is not. There, you have to create your own way of networking. You could be the person who's in an event talking to 3, 4, 5 people, full day event and hundreds of people and coming back. Perfectly okay. The more you tell yourself, I can't do this, I can't do this, I can't do this, the less you will be able to do of what you can do, right? So stop selling that drama. Get out of it, right? And if you are ready to take your networking skill to the next level, go to networkingsuccess.in, check out the 3-day event. It's a game-changing workshop, right? Come to that. I look forward to seeing you there, right? So that's all for today. Definitely leave a comment. Let me know what you thought of this. Did this help? Do you have any more questions? Do you have any other topic, right, that you want me to bring up in these lives? I'm trying to be very regular with this now. Okay, cool. So do that. And remember to check out networkingsuccess.in. Tanuj has put that link in the chat box. I look forward to seeing you there. God bless, right? Cool. Now, how do I end this? Oh my God. First time live from my... Okay, this says finish up, right? Cool, guys. Bye-bye. See you soon.